Hi guys, today we're going to step away from a fitness topic a little bit, and let me start this video by a personal story. So one of the happiest moments of my life was the day when I passed the physical therapy boards exam. And it was a truly happy moment because now all that work studying English, 4 years of undergrad, 3 years of grad school, having to manage kids, work, school, training and everything else was finally over. An American dream came true, and I started working right away, and so now instead of paying all that crazy money for college tuition, I was getting all that money in my account that I wasn't used to, and it was very, very nice. But it didn't take long for me to start getting this little strange feeling that maybe something wasn't quite right. And the more I thought about it, the more depressing my reality started to appear, because I started to realize that I made all those sacrifices just to put myself in the position where I was gonna have to work for the rest of my life. And now, the best thing I have to look forward to is getting old and retiring. And so, whose idea was that? And I think when we are kids, we are given the script and we are told that if you just follow the plan, everything's gonna work out.
Nobody panics when things go according to plan.
And let me just say here that I do understand that becoming a doctor of physical therapy in the United States of America is probably not the worst thing that could possibly happen to me. And I've been to some of the darkest corners on this planet, and I do understand that this lifestyle is beyond what a lot of people around the world could possibly ask for. But at the same time, we also have to think that there might be something wrong with this notion where we have to spend most of our lives either working or in school preparing for work. And so I decided to break away from this conventional trajectory. And so today I want to share some of the things that I've learned in the process. But let me just mention here that just because I know a little bit about strength training, it doesn't mean that now I got all the answers, and I'm not an influencer or a motivational speaker, and I'm a little skeptical of all those things, and I do not believe that there is a bulletproof recipe for success. And instead, let me give you one of my favorite quotes, which is, success occurs when opportunity meets preparation, meaning that to a certain degree you still have to be lucky enough to be at the right place at the right time. But at the same time, it doesn't mean that you can just sit on your ass and wait for good things to happen. You are still responsible for the preparation part. And so, for example, another one of the happiest moments of my life was when I received green card, and so I was able to move to United States. But do understand that me moving to United States meant that I was leaving all my friends behind, my family behind, and I was showing up here at JFK not speaking any English, not having any money, and not knowing anybody. And now I have to try to make something of myself. And there is a lot of crime in the West for some reason recently. But do understand that majority of the people all over the world would gladly trade places with anybody in one of these Western countries. And unless you are dealing with some unfortunate disability, the chances are that you already have this part going for you. And so today, we're gonna focus mostly on this. But one more thing before we get started is that this is mostly for guys, because I can only speak from a man's perspective. And I do suspect that the formula might have slightly different ingredients for women. And speaking of women, the first one on our list is no women diet. And this one is probably going to be the most counterintuitive for a lot of guys. And obviously, if you are happily married, this one does not apply. But otherwise, this is what I have for you guys. So, a few years ago, I was coming out of this a bit messy relationship. And as some of you might know, the first instinct is always to get back on the horse and prove that you still got it. But that time, I decided to do something slightly different. And so, I decided to take a break from dating for at least 30 days. And interesting things started happening almost right away, because the more I pulled away from this, the more I started to realize how much time and effort I devote to being successful with women. And this is when I started watching some of my guy friends, and it was exactly the same thing. Almost everything we do as men, directly or indirectly, is designed to make us suitable candidates with women. And I know a lot of guys are not going to want to admit it, but let me tell you something. I know for sure that none of you guys are wearing these tight ass pants that crushing your balls when you're by yourself in your house. I know you wouldn't be driving these, leasing these cars that you can never afford. I know you wouldn't be standing in these clubs pretending that you enjoy dancing. It would be much cheaper for you to have some drinks with your friends in your house. And it goes even deeper than that, because even some of the biggest decisions that we make to at least some degree is affected by how that's gonna affect our success with women. And it's not until you step away from this for a while when you start seeing how much time and effort you really devote to this. And it's not just about time and effort, because it's almost in a way like a stepping out of the cloud and seeing things clearly for the first time and actually seeing what's really best for you. And back home we have an expression that you can't be a little pregnant. So you're either pregnant or you're not pregnant. And it applies for a lot of these things here, because this is not about playing hard to get. And then the first time the hot girl smiles at you, you forget where you are. Because women will test your commitment. Because hot girls are not used to not having this unspoken influence on the guys around them. And so when you hear that you're probably gay or you are impotent, know that you are doing this right. And things will also be different when you finally decide to go back to dating, whenever that may be, because now you know that you are okay by yourself and you're not really looking for somebody to complete you and make you whole again. And now you know that women are supposed to complement your life and not be the focus of it. And so you might not be as accommodating and you might have these boundaries that everybody's talking about. But even just in general, I believe that this is an excellent first step to take from this conventional script that I mentioned earlier. And instead of doing what you're supposed to, you can just focus on doing what's best for you. Number two on our list is shut off your social media. So when Facebook just came out, it was all about staying in touch with friends. So for example, I have friends all over the place. And so I could use Facebook to sort of update them on what I've been doing and also see what they've been up to. And so it was kind of nice. But needless to say that that's not what social media is all about anymore. And all it is nowadays is a place for people to compete for who has the coolest life. Oh, so this is me at the party and this is what I'm eating. And it's one thing when girls do it, but when guys do it, it's just too pathetic. And I do understand that social media and Instagram in particular has dating applications, but as we already established, that's not the priority at the moment. Now, Twitter is in a slightly different category, but a huge waste of time nevertheless, because you might feel like you're there to support some political views, but in reality, conversation just keeps going until one of the participants realizes that this is a waste of time and stops replying, and then the other party feels like they won the argument. So, huge waste of time, and get rid of that. Now, do understand that all those apps are designed by very smart people, and they are designed specifically to keep you as engaged as possible. And this is why when you point out to somebody that maybe they're a little preoccupied with their phone, they will tell you very seriously that what they're looking at right now is actually very serious. And so what I'm saying is that there's going to be at least some level of withdrawal going on if you're trying to pull away from it. But if you are successful with breaking that addiction, you will be surprised how much free time you have on your hands all of a sudden. Time that you can spend doing something a little more productive. So for example, I used to take a train ride to my work and it was about 30 minutes. And just like everybody else, I was scrolling through Instagram, looking at the pictures of Instagram fitness models posting pictures of their asses, grown men. And once I shut it off, I didn't know what to do with myself, especially if you look around and everybody else is scrolling through BS. And next thing you know, I'm reading books. And if you read as much, and if you spend as much time reading as you would otherwise scrolling through nonsense, you'd be surprised how much reading you can do in a week. And if you don't know where to start, I actually have a video where I talk about some of the books that are recommended to my daughter. Now, do understand that it's not just about freeing up the time. And just like with dating, a lot of it has to do with just clearing your head. Because as I mentioned earlier, social media is all about, to some degree at least, it's all about competing with everybody else about who has the coolest life. And the odds are against you because you are competing with everybody else's highlights. And so there is some kind of competition anxiety going on that people are not going to want to admit.
Psychology Today says the average high school kid has the same level of anxiety as the average psychiatric patient in the early 1950s. And that's directly related to social media.
But if you are successful with breaking away from it, I can guarantee you, you might not be in a rush to jump back into it ever again. And let me just, before we move on, mention that I do allow myself YouTube, because there are a lot of smart people talking about a lot of interesting things on YouTube, and you can actually learn a lot, quite a bit. But let me just specify that none of the fitness pages are in that category. I currently do not follow a single fitness page, and it's not because I know it all already. It just, the point is that, the bottom line is that there is just not that much to strength and conditioning for people to keep posting videos every week or so for years and years and years. And so, like I said, I allow myself YouTube, but you have to be very careful to make sure that that doesn't turn into masturbation as well. Number three on our list is get fit. And I know a lot of you guys are probably very surprised to see this one on my list. But let's just be clear right away that we are not talking about just looking good. We're talking about being healthy and being able to perform physical tasks. So you are ready for whatever life throws at you. You are ready to go that extra mile when it's necessary. So at my last job, I used to work a lot of overtime. And my rationale was that if I'm there for a particular rate, I might as well be there for time and a half of that rate. But all my coworkers would always be puzzled how I'm not tired all the time. And mind you, I'm talking about work at the hospital with AC, heat, elevators, and so on. And my point here is that we are getting soft in the West. And people seem to exaggerate every little feeling they ever get. I'm starving, I'm freezing, I'm exhausted.
And I'm sensing you're a bit of a bitch.
And it used to be that feelings were mostly for women, but now it's guys too. And don't be in a rush to think that you aren't an exception, because it applies for all of us. Just look up the decline in testosterone levels or fertility rates among men in the last few decades. That stuff is alarming. And I might be wrong, but I personally don't believe it has anything to do with the plastic. It's probably just some nonsense that environmental people came up with. And I do believe that it has everything to do with this excessive domestication of men. Oh, he's too aggressive. Oh, he's too competitive. And this is your chance of redemption right here, guys, because luckily, it's still acceptable to be aggressive and competitive at the gym. And so no shortcuts, no steroids, no stupid personal trainers, no bariatric surgeries, none of that nonsense. Learn how to exercise properly and figure out how to make it a permanent part of your life. And the information that we have on this channel, combined with my books, covers everything you need to know. I was talking to a friend of mine a while ago, and she was telling me how she was struggling to lose weight. And so we talked about the diet a little bit, and then the exercise topic came up. And so she told me that she was doing yoga. And I was like, well, yoga is not necessarily the best way to lose weight. But her rationale was the following. Well, I think yoga is fun, and since I enjoy it so much, there's a higher chance of me sticking to it. And that rationale makes sense if you are talking to a child. I wasn't talking to a child, I was talking to a grown woman who was at least 100 pounds overweight. And my point here is that you don't get very far in life if you only do what you think is fun. And I think we're very good these days at rewarding ourselves for every little accomplishment. Ooh, I walked 2 flights of stairs at work today, I'm gonna treat myself with some yogurt. But when it comes to penalizing yourself for some undesirable behaviors, people have no idea what that would even be like. So for example, people talk to me about how they can't stick to a diet because they might have eating disorder. Well, that's not impossible, but I always tell them, do you have entertainment disorder? Huh? So I'm like, how about this? How about you shut off all your streaming services on top of social media until you reach a desired weight? Still no progress? How about sleeping on the floor disorder? No sleeping on the floor disorder? So how about this? How about you sleep on the floor every day you screw up with your diet or skip the training session on top of no entertainment? Still no progress? How about cold showers disorder? No cold showers disorder? So how about this? Every day you screw up with the diet or skip the training session, you're taking a cold shower, sleeping on the floor on top of no entertainment. And if you have guts to go through with this, at some point you will reach a level of discomfort when it's just easier to stick to the diet. Or at least you will find out that you don't have eating disorder. You probably just have a lack of willpower. And by the way, this is how discipline is being forged in the military. There is no magic why people get very disciplined very fast in the military. And the same thing goes for martial arts. Good coaches use punishment all the time. Oh, you late to practice? 100 push-ups. You forgot your jump rope? 50 burpees. And next thing you know, you never late to practice and you never forget your jump rope, because you remember pain. But unfortunately, punishment is being taken out of our school system these days. God forbid some kids' feelings get hurt.
There's so many kids that have been raised to be safe and secure every moment. Anything that's insecure or unsafe, they don't want to be a part of, including language. And what it does is make you incredibly weak and fearful.
And even me saying word punishment might trigger some people. But this is your chance of redemption right here. This is how you can learn the discipline, learn consistency, patience, perseverance, and all these other things. And I do believe that how you perform in this area will be a good predictor how the rest of this is going to go. Number four on our list is start investing. And we have two subcategories here. So in yourself and stock market. When you have some free time, I encourage you to take a piece of paper and make three columns on it. So in the first column, you will put all the activities that you do in your life for you to preserve your current way of life. So like work, sleep, bathing, and so on. In the second column, you will put all the activities that you do for the pure enjoyment of it. So like going out, Netflix, and so on. And in the third column, you will put all the activities that you do with the expectation that it will benefit you in the future. So the school is the easiest example, because this is something that you do now, hoping that it will help you to get a better job later on. Now, it's important to understand that the same activity can fall into different categories depending on the circumstances, or could even fall in multiple categories at the same time. So, for example, I personally like to exercise, and so it could easily be in the fun category for me. But it could easily be in the maintenance category as well, because we all know that exercising is good for you to stay healthy. Still, it's better to decide on what is the primary purpose of a particular activity specifically for you, because otherwise things can get a little messy. So for example, some of you might heard me telling the story that when I was in the military, I was getting a lot of physical therapy because of all the injuries. And it always helped. And so when I was getting out, I decided to become a physical therapist. And I was very excited. But little did I know was that you're supposed to go to college and study mostly unrelated nonsense before you can even apply to physical therapy school, because our school system right now is an equivalent of taking a bucket of sand and throwing it against the wall and hoping that some of it will stick. And you better believe that I did not have any fun doing any of that. But what helped me to get through was clear understanding that it wasn't meant to be fun, because school was supposed to be an investment. And this is why I believe that something as simple as this can help you to get a clear picture of what you're doing with your life. Because for example, if you're very unhappy, your first instinct might be to have more fun. But how you expect things to change in your life if you have nothing going for you in the investment category? Because being busy and being productive are not the same thing. Because we like to be busy today. People that do bare minimum will tell you that they have so much going on, have so many balls up in the air. But take away these two columns, these two categories right here, and see how many balls up in the air you really have. And if you really don't have anything going for you in the investment category, well, first of all, it's not true, because we already decided that you're supposed to have physical training in this category. And another one is school. Another one is education. You just have to make sure that you don't pick some useless major and then drown yourself in loans on top of it, because then that it becomes a bit of a questionable investment. Now, after that, it's whatever your interests are. So, for example, I used to do a lot of martial arts back in the day, and although I did not get to the point where I could make a living doing that, it still expanded my skill a lot, because I could easily do that, do coaching for a living now, because people are willing to pay a lot of money for those kind of things. Now, another one that could be here is programming. So I personally thought that that field was already saturated, but it turned out that that's not the case. And a friend of mine just quit his primary job and now making very good money just doing that. Now, we'll talk a little more about this in a moment, but let's just talk about the financial investment for now. So let's say you have your education completed and you have your career on track and you're making some money. You should probably put some of that money aside. And I'm personally a big fan of the stock market, and I think that this is one of the greatest things about capitalism. And quite frankly, I'm a little tired hearing people complaining about how rich are getting richer and inequality is rising and blah 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 blah. Some of you guys got paid very well for sitting at home during the pandemic. Some of my friends got unemployment that was almost equal to the salary I was getting for working directly with COVID patients in the hospital in one of the most affected areas in the country. Now, that's a little unfair if you ask me, but that's a whole different topic. And what I'm saying here is that at least some of their money could be saved. Just look up prices of some of the main stocks during the pandemic. Everything at least doubled or tripled since then. And that could be your money, but instead, all my friends engaged in revenge spending because they felt that they earned it by getting paid for sitting at home. And my point here is that if you're wearing stupid Jordans or you have iPhone 10 or above in your pocket, you don't get to complain about inequality. And this is the difference between rich people and poor people, because poor people buying iPhones and rich people are buying stocks of Apple. And I do understand that not everybody's in the same position to invest. So for example, I wasn't buying stocks when I was in college, and I was just trying to keep my head above water and trying to get through it without taking any loans. And by the way, if people getting loan forgiveness, I would like my money back as well. But again, that's a separate discussion. And even now, I don't have as much as, let's say, Elon Musk. But that's okay, as long as my little share grows at the same rate as his. And that's the beauty of the stock market, because we can all have a little piece of success of all these incredible corporations and make all these very smart people, like Elon Musk, for example, to work for us and work to make us richer. And obviously not everybody feels the same way about this. And I do believe that our government is probably responsible for changing our attitudes towards capitalism in the United States of all places. Because this way, we are too busy worrying about corporations monopolizing everything instead of taking a closer look at how tax money is being spent. Oh, look at Johnson & Johnson got everybody hooked on opioids. Really? Johnson & Johnson can sell drugs directly to patients? Wasn't it FDA's responsibility to enforce proper regulations? But you don't hear people talking about that. And I envision a future where all citizens have a little stake in all of these main private companies. And as they are growing, we all get a little richer. And I believe that this will become more and more important as so-called automation takes place and a lot of the jobs will get replaced by machines. And wouldn't it be nice if we all benefited from that in the form of dividends instead of relying on our government for this redistribution with the basic universal income? Because last time I checked, for me to receive dividends from Microsoft, they don't have to break into somebody's house and demand 30% of everything you earn. And this is the part that people often forget, that in order for our government to spend money, they first have to take that money from us. And if you think about this a little more, you might feel a little different about how much we spend on Paris Agreement or in foreign aid to countries that seem to be pretty well developed. And our government is always very good at making themselves look like good guys.
The trampling of racial justice is a cause of climate change.
And, you know, they always mean well, but that still implies that we have to assume that people working for our government are more intelligent or noble than people working for Amazon or Google, for example. And we don't really have any reasons to believe that. And as a matter of fact, I would argue that the opposite is the case. And if you know people that work for DMV, FAA, border security, you name it, you know that that's probably true, because none of those people went to work there to make difference or to work hard. And we really don't have any reason to believe that it's any different at the higher level. And so why give more money to our noble government to waste? And I actually have a separate video where I talk about that. But just to bring it back to this, to finish up this one, I just want to talk a little bit about the buying property. So buying a house is excellent, but as long as you can afford it. Because I see a lot of people that get into these mortgages that are almost equal to their salaries. And now they have 30 years to look forward to, 30 years of that to look forward to. And I'm not a fan of that, because that's almost like voluntarily enslaving yourself. And now your boss wants you to stay on the weekend, you say yes. Now your boss wants you to stay late, you say yes. I mean, that's no way to live, in my opinion.
The things you own end up owning you.
The last one we have is side hustle. So personally, I'm a big believer in doing a little extra on the side. These days, we hear all these people talking about being entrepreneur. But what if you really don't have any good business ideas? Plus, not everybody can just quit everything and start a new business, especially if you have people relying on you, like your parents or your kids, for example. But the good thing is that you don't have to dive at the deep end, and you can just start with a little investment and then see how it plays out. So for example, I mentioned martial arts earlier, and do understand that I did not quit school and my job when I was doing it. And when injuries started piling up and I realized that I was getting a little too old for it, it wasn't the end of the world. Now, another one is, if you guys watch my introduction video, I talked about how it all started with the app, and then it led to the books, and then it led to the YouTube channel. But do understand that, once again, I did not quit my job when I was doing it. As a matter of fact, I had two jobs at that time. And if none of that ever worked out, it wouldn't be the end of the world. And I would still learn a lot in the process. Because just a few years ago, what did I know about making apps or publishing books or editing videos? And you just never know how one thing is gonna lead to another. And besides, on top of it, just knowing that you're doing a little extra with your life has its own value, because you're not just stuck in some dead end job like most of your coworkers, just sitting there and waiting to die. And you have in the back of your mind this, you have this hope that your preparation will meet opportunity one day and you'll hit the jackpot. And do understand, guys, that it's not just about the money. It's about the freedom. It's about not having to worry about the bills. It's about not having to worry about your supervisors having a bad day. And money is just a means to an end. And just to finish up, I want to answer a question about why am I even getting myself into this, and why can't I just stay in my lane and talk about fitness? Well, first of all, as I already mentioned, there is just really not that much to talk about when it comes to resistance training. And plus, on top of it, I feel like there is a lot of strange stuff that's happening in our society. I think there is some malevolent growing within our government.
You're moving one step closer to dictatorship. That's what the f*** is happening.
I think the situation with our education system is very peculiar, and I do believe that somebody actually wants it that way. And on top of it, I think that just being a man in the West these days puts you at risk, especially us privileged white men. And I don't want to just sit quietly and watch all this happening. And this is why I am exercising my freedom of speech here, although that's also a bit iffy these days, and we'll see how all this works out for me. But in any case, I appreciate your guys' support, and I hope that you found at least some of this helpful.
Comrades, we stand here. We die here. It has been an honor.
Buy my book before it's too late, people.